Good day, fellow investors. A few weeks ago, I made a good video about copper being one of my best investment theses. How I'm very bullish on copper over the next 5-10 years. I think it's cheap, the economics, the difficulty of mining it, it's getting harder and harder. And how over the next 5-10 years, the copper price will go higher. And therefore is why I'm invested in. And then I got a lot of emails asking me, okay, Sven, what is a good copper company to buy? I have one, I'm owning one company that's a pure copper miner. One is exposed to copper and another one a little bit. But I found one company that's a great company, a great copper miner. The price is perhaps a little bit higher, but it is one to watch and one that I have put on my cover, stocks that I cover. I have 30 companies that I cover, I look, I adjust for earnings, and I wait for them, those price to fit my entry point. That's what I do on my stock market research platform. You can check that out whenever you want. The link is in the description below. All my research is less than $1 per day, so less than a cup of coffee with me per day, and you get everything that I do, structured, every trade, everything. So check it out when you get the time. Now let's go to Southern Copper Corporation. It has all the qualities of a great business and all the qualities I look when I look at stocks. But then when it comes to investing, you also have to look at, okay, what's going on? What are the catalysts? What might happen? When what might happen? And what might impact the stock price? Will it be a better bargain in the future? And can I buy it at a discount at some point in time? Which is something I think I can, I might be able to do. When you have 30 stocks, it's enough that three of those become a bargain in a year and you do really, really well. So it might not. Let me give you an overview of the company, why I think it's a great business, what is the current valuation, what is the current expected return from my earnings model, and then you'll see how this fits your portfolio, whether you want to cover it, to follow it, put it on your watch list, or whether you want just to follow what I do and have me cover it, follow earnings, follow the industry, things that happen for you. Let's start. So Southern Copper Corporation, when I looked at last time, 2018, it was very expensive, but now the stock price is significantly down. However, because of copper is down, expected recession, everything. But when you look at such things, when you see great companies going down, then it's always good to check them out. So Southern Copper is a company that has mines, copper mines in Mexico and Peru, and they have very good mines. And what I really like about them is that they have 70 years of mining ahead of them. There are a lot of mining companies that can mine for 5-10 years, have good economics, but what's next? What's after after the 10th year? Well, they don't have to worry at Southern Copper about that because they have great mines, great assets, and they are a low-cost producer. When it comes to mining, there are always issues. Mining is not nice, but it is necessary for the world we live in. So there are protests again against the 1.4 billion new copper project that they plan to do in Peru. This will delay things. It has already been delayed for a decade due to projects, and we will see how that works out over the long term. But these projects are not everything that the company is. The company is diversified across many projects, and that's what actually makes it interesting and gives it the value. As you can see, the cash cost is then very low, and this is another benefit on top of the 70 years of production. So diversification with many projects and extremely low cash costs. If you look at the cost curve for copper miners, it is at the lowest cost curve in the world. Glencore is also low, but Glencore has high debt attached to that mining. Then we have Teck. Teck is exposed to coal. Vale, okay, low copper cost, but then iron ore, BHP differentiated, etc., etc. And then you have those very leveraged copper miners that if copper prices go down are in trouble. But Southern Copper, if copper prices go down, they will make $1 billion, $2 billion less, but they will unlikely go bust because of their low copper mining costs. So that is the second advantage on top of the 70 years of mining ahead. And then the third key component of this company, they have been growing production slow and steady over the last 10 years. So really increasing production on those low costs, on the quality of their assets, investing on a high return on capital invested. And their plan is to continue to do so in the future and increase production 105% over the next 7, 8, 10 years. If they do that, this stock will just be a double just because they increased production. If then all the copper fundamentals that we discussed in the other video evolve, this can also be a triple in the next 10 years. So that is a great return. Plus, they already have cash flows, they are paying a dividend, so they are rewarding shareholders. So a lot of things to like here. However, in the past, capital expenditures were around 1 billion per year. They plan to push that up to 2 billion per year. So that might put pressure on dividends. If copper prices go lower, the dividend might be cut. And whenever there is a dividend cut, there is so much selling because nobody wants to buy a company without a dividend, or a company that just cut a dividend, or those holding stocks just for the dividend are going for something else. And that's usually the best time to buy. So I'm waiting here for a period where capital expenditures are extremely high, revenues from copper, cash flows from copper are low due to low copper prices, perhaps a recession that leads the company to cut the dividend, that leads the stock price to fall down. And then I'm going to look at this great asset if it is a bargain, of course, compared to other investing opportunities. For now, if we look at my earnings model, I get to 3 billion in cash flow, very conservatively estimated, in 2025. That's a 10% yield on current levels, 28 billion market capitalization, which is not enough for me. I'm looking for earnings yields of 15% today or in the future. But if there is a dividend yield of 10% in 2025, the stock will definitely double. The dividend yield will fall to 5%. So that's already a good return. If you add that 7% when the stock doubles over per year, plus 3-5% of dividend, that's a 15% return you can expect from this company over the long term, which is not bad and would fit many very portfolios very, very well. However, for me, it's not enough now. I have a little bit better miners for now. I'm covering this. We'll adjust for earnings, update, see how things work. But this is a great, great asset to look at, add and follow and add when it's really, really cheap, because it can be a portfolio gem. Thank you for watching. Looking forward to your comments. I hope you enjoyed this. This is a really good company. And for now, I'm going to cover, look at what the management does, says, has done. Look at the annual report. I still have to dig deep, but it's on my cover list. So over time, I give myself a lot of time to really learn a company in depth and then compare it to other opportunities and then see whether it is a buy or not. Thank you for watching. Looking forward to your comments, and I'll see you in the next video.